everyone. It's the NBA on 2K Sports. We're bringing it to you live. Well, a chance to check out some stats for Ja Morant. And he's been outstanding offensively as of late. These last five games, he's been a beast at the offensive end. A different level scorer than he had been earlier in the season. Let's see if he can keep it up.
Now the starting group for the visitors.
Delon Wright is out there with Desmond Bane. Then it's Clint Capella. Then it's Rui Hachimura. And it's Nesmith in at the three. Cunningham is out there with Ja Morant. Then it's Amadou Diallo. Then there's Al Horford. And it's Portis in at the five down low. All right, tonight's game will break a winning streak for one of these clubs, Doris.
Oh, my goodness, B.A. We have been so looking forward to this matchup. Both teams have been playing exceptional basketball. They've strung together some wins. One of these teams is going to walk out of here disappointed.
And the technical free throw is good.
You know, Cade Cunningham has proven he can get it done on offense. Now, check this out. Back in college, he racked up 13 points in just 91 seconds of play.
With the drive. The rebound by Nesmith. Over Diallo. Second chance effort. Horford with the block. Diallo against Wright. Diallo passes to Morant. And Morant gets double teamed. Here's Cunningham. Ooh, pops the chain. Cunningham's ability to find points really is impressive, Brent. You hope he has as much success in the league as he did in college.
And yeah, B.A., with his pure shooting ability, I know he has what it takes. He just needs to put in the work and be ready to adapt to league play.
Pass to Morant. Plenty of space. And the jumper is good.
Morant stays nimble, and that allows him to make any needed adjustment to his shot.
There's Nesmith with the three. Here's Capella, and the layup is good off the glass.
Wow, he really fires up his team with his ability to extend possessions.
Horford with it, the three is up, sinks the tray.
Well, he's got such big time mobility for a big man. Al Horford specializes in finding the gaps in the defense. Nice catch and shoot.
And it's Wright missing. Gone 3 of 4 to get things going. To Morant. And Morant gets double teamed. Back to Diallo. Capella with a rebound. The Kings have gone 2 of 6 from the floor. Right outside. Let's the three fly. He drops it from range. Wright's got 6.
Boy, Delon Wright with great range. What a shot.
Pass to Morant. So far. Here's Nesmith, and he trains the quick shot.
Well, there are times where the court vision gets questioned, but Rui Hachimura, the delivery, sets up his teammate. Really well done.
Morant with it. All right, defending. And yep, it's good. He's got 5.
Pounding it inside early and often.
Deciding to change it up. All right, let's look back over the last 10 games now. See which teams were topping the charts in three-point shooting. The Kings, number one.
Number one, you have to have good shooters. Number two, you have to take good shots. This team is both talented and disciplined.
Here's Jones. The wide-open shot is on the money.
And that's just nasty right there, guys. He has a tremendous crossover.
To the paint. Here's Morant.
From the point guard.
Oh, I love backcourt players with some ups.
We know versatility is huge in this game. Just a tremendous job finishing that play. Wow.
Inside. And stolen by Williams. From deep 3-point range. And Morant clears the board. second basket on the night.
I love this approach. Getting him involved early, and it's already paying off.
They know that if this guy goes off, their chances of winning rise exponentially.
The three is up. And that one's good. Rozier.
That's been typical of their performance today. They're sharing the ball and creating good shots.
Here's Sumner. Releases from the wing and drills it.
Well, you love the activity out there. What a play. This guy is busy on the offensive end.
Down low. Here's Zubac.
And Morant is a natural leader, someone who wants to get his guys involved when they're open.
Williams misses. Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. Pass to Morant, and Morant gets double teamed. Here's Vince Diop, and he throws it down. What a terrific lead pass.
Defensively, you can't afford to let him get to the rim that easily.
Well, that might be why their deficit is what it is right now.
I tell you, you can't get stops if you're unwilling to put in the work.
Here's Dozier. Takes it inside. Oh, he took the contact and tried to throw it down over the top. Instead, he'll shoot free throws.
Nice job to go at the rack and force the foul.
First free throw is good. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time. 7 seconds left to play in the first. And stolen by Williams. A free-flowing first quarter. Great spin neck and neck, but plenty of time left in this one. And from what we've seen here from the home team, what's your take so far?
It's all about the strong inside-out game in the first period. It really helped them get some clean looks down low.
It is great when you can get that established early, because to me it opens up every other aspect of your game.
Taking a look at the Kings, we've got Nesmith. Rui Hachimura is out there with Clint Capella. Then it's Desmond Bain, and it's Wright in at the point. Here's Cunningham. And he can't extend the lead to double digits. Well, the Kings shooting around 39%. They'd like to get that higher. Hey, no good.
Boy, what a career it has been for Al Horford. A decade and a half in the league. He has been
Capella takes the 12-footer and hits it.
Yeah, when you make your mid-range shots, you force your opponents to adjust.
Well, truth is, though, he's tall enough to get that off against anyone.
And it's Cunningham missing. And Al Horford, he still shapes a game. Double-digit score his whole career.
Well, think back to his collegiate career. Back-to-back championships, such a rare accomplishment. And his NBA career has found him a key contributor on some excellent teams.
And that one is right through.
Well, a seven-footer showing how easy it can be. Enes Kanter, aggressive.
Capella can't get it to go.
Nice rebound. Trying to match the other team's intensity right now.
Diallo outside. Pass to Cunningham. To the inside. It's stolen by Wright. Here's Capella. And he wills that one in. Taking it right through the back of the iron. Capella's got 6 in the quarter.
Scoring well this quarter. Picking up steam as he goes.
To the middle. Ooh, power down with both hands.
Ow. Slams it down with two hands.
Man, they're really getting aggressive now. Here's Bane. Horford pulls it in. Horford's got 5 rebounds tonight. Williams passes to Diallo. To the right side. Down low. It's stolen by Wright. Here's Nesmith. Kept alive. Hachimura. And that's good. His first bucket of the game.
Second chance opportunity.
Institutions here. And Grant, you were named co-rookie of the year alongside Jason Kidd back in 95. Something that's only happened 3 times in NBA history.
Yeah, I'm still bitter about that. I was robbed. Jason knows that. Everyone knows that. Nah, Jason and I, we are good friends. We joke about this all the time, but it was really an honor to share this award with someone of this caliber. Really one of the true greats to
quick shot. Sumner's gotten his second bucket of the game.
Good passing to set that up. Teamwork on display.
Portis with a screen on Williams. Out to Portis. There's the triple. And a great assist by Morant as that one goes.
Yes.
Morant's got his ninth assist of the game now. The Kings have gotten five of their first 11 shots to fall here in the second quarter. From 18 feet away. And it's good. Off the back of the rim and in. Jones has got his third bucket of the night. Outside Morant. Picked his pocket. And they're on the break. Shoots from 12. Williams misses.
And it's amazing. Their slim advantage on the board seems a lot larger than it is.
Gets the three ball to go. Give him eight.
I mean, I guess they're willing to give him that shot. They may want to rethink that strategy, though.
The shot by Sumner, no good.
And for him, that's a great look. Expect him to go right back to it if it's available.
No doubt. Very good play call, good execution. Sometimes it just doesn't fall.
To the wing on the left is Dozier. Hits a three-pointer.
12 straight points out of threes. This defense is not extending very well.
Here's Williams. Money on the 19-footer. Williams has got his first 2 points of the night.
And the D having issues slowing down their mid-range game.
Morant with it. Started now by Williams. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair.
Love the attacking mindset of Morant. Gets him to the line.
At the line for two.
And the second free throw is good. 24 seconds left in the first half. Puts one up from 19 and off the glass. That one's good. Jones has gotten four this quarter.
Oh, man. They have really heated up from mid-range.
Here's Dozier. And a great assist by Morant as that one goes.
Listen, he's streaking. But if he gets hot, you've got to run people out of anything you can do to disrupt his rhythm. You have to have the vision to find the open man. Beautiful pass.
Here's Zubats outside. Oh, and the release was before the buzzer, but it's off target. And the Kings shooting at a 48% clip from the floor. Al Horford out there with Hamidou Diallo. Then there's Cunningham. Then there's Ja Morant. And it's Portis in at the pivot spot, manning the middle.
And they're plus five on the boards after that rebound.
And for the Kings, Clint Capella out there with Rui Hachimura. Then it's DeLon Wright. Then it's Nesmith. And it's Bane in at the two spot. Down to five on the shot clock. Diallo with the ball. Hachimura covering. Horford for three. Pure from three-point range. Horford's got 11 points.
Well, the incredible shooting touch of Al Horford. He added that range game during his time in Atlanta.
Shooting about 70% from the floor. Hard to do better than that. Pass to Morant. Driving in. Here's Cunningham. It's Portis. High post. Outside Morant. Shoots over Nesmith. Morant, no good. And if you're just joining us, we've played just over a minute here in the third.
How about the touch? To be the difference between an assist and a turnover. Nice delivery.
Adjustments are a part of every game.
Adjustments. Looking ahead a few moves and trying to execute toward that.
Diallo passes to Morant, and Morant gets double-teamed. Now Horford. The three! And it's Cunningham missing. Here's Nesmith, covered by Diallo.
Yeah.
Yep, count it. He's got six. Just a little over 90 seconds gone in the third quarter. And it's Morant off the drive. And it's off the back of the rim. No good.
Listen, simply put, he's got to finish that. It's not like the defender was right on top of him.
Goes back up. And his fifth basket. Five for eight. Looking comfortable out there.
Refusing to give up on the glass. Capella truly works for his rebounds.
Here's Morant. Oh, there's Morant.
the slam. Oh, excellent way to pad the lead.
Yeah, especially when it's your one throwing it down like that.
That's got to be a little bit deflating to the defense, guys. Getting kicked when you're down. My goodness.
An easy two on the layup. Morant's got 4 points this quarter.
Well, this guy has been efficient and effective all night. That IQ has been on display.
They get it back. Neesmith. And there's two. Work on the glass, man. Off that time.
You can see it. He's taking better shots, and the results are coming because of it.
Morant drawing the double team. Well-timed pass, and it goes straight to the bucket for the layup.
Well, the touch that Enes Kanter presents is really terrific. Unbelievable scoring inside.
And here are the top shooters at the point guard position in this year's freshman class. Second is Ja Morant.
They're just some fantastic shooters on that list.
You love point guards who have great touch as well as the patience to wait for good looks.
You know, that intelligence is really their hallmark. Always taking the smart shot, never forcing it when it's not there. You know, that's how they're able to keep their percentages so high. That and the fact that they can flat out shoot.
A chance here to catch up with Allie from the sideline.
Thanks, Brian. Historically, a few franchises have gobbled up most of the NBA championships. A significant number of teams have never won a title. However, aren't it interesting times? A lot of those franchises are looking for their first title. They're among the top teams now. And guys, they're hoping to get on the board.
Oh, yes. Very interesting, Alex. Thanks for that.
They're surprised he doesn't have more shot attempts. He's been accurate. You think he'd want to take the
dynamic. I mean, every night Morant makes incredible plays, and that extends as well to his passing.
Here's Jones. He gets it. He's 7-for-8 and really going at him out there.
There's some nice chemistry on offense. They're just taking what the defense allows.
Pass to Bates Diop. Good. And the setup by Morant. He's got five.
And just shredding apart the defense with his passing. He's helping to pace this offense so well.
And I think they count on him for that. He is a tone setter, extremely unselfish.
They've struggled, but hey, you cannot lay it at his feet. Offensively, he's getting it done.
Out to the right wing. The open shot, Morant. A good-looking shot on the wing. Morant's got 13.
Plays with so much confidence. When Morant gets in a zone, he stays aggressive.
Here's Jones. Sumner checked in for Bane. There's 37 seconds left in the third. Here's Cunningham. He's been an offensive weapon for them, scoring around 17 and a half points a game. And now let's revisit that exceptional mobile one block.
Oh, now that was a block. Some much-needed energy there to jumpstart them back into this game.
And we've got 28 seconds left to play in the third quarter of basketball.
Assistant, Zaire Williams.
The Kings have gotten 8 of 14 attempts to go in the second half so far. Here's Jones. Good on the 13th footer. Jones has got 9 points in the quarter, shooting 69%. I think they're even surprising themselves out there. Outside Morant. And there's the drive. Oh, there's Morant with the slam.
The quick feet of Morant. So dangerous when he's cutting to the rim.
17-foot shot on the way. It's good. Off the glass. Jones has got 11 in the second half.
He's bringing a lot of energy to this offense. Not letting the scoreboard discourage him right now.
But to me, he's just playing smart, efficient basketball, really helping his team hang around this one.
And here at the end of the look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
Zero chances.
Well, that's what a great pass would do, right? You love the unselfish play.
And one quarter to go in a game that, to this point, has not been an evenly fought contest. They've got Ja Morant. He's out there with Amadou Diallo. And it's Horford in at the power forward position. picks up the foul. That's his first foul.
Hey, they are really exploiting openings in the mid-range. 10 straight points from that area.
Baines checks in for Jones.
It just seems like everything is going their way.
To the left wing. Horford for three. Baines, 6 attempts. He's made 5. Talk about efficiency.
This defense just can't stay connected to shooters.
There's Nesmith for the three. Horford pulls it in.
And this is exactly who you want taking that shot. He just missed it.
What energy on the offensive boards. The defense can't match the effort, and they paid the price.
And so he draws the foul. Headed to the line to shoot a pair. On Saturday, they'll be playing against Eric Bledsoe, and on Monday, they'll be matching up with LeBron James.
It's no secret around the league that this team loves playing in their own building. They're loaded with home games over the next stretch, so this is a chance to win some ball games.
Cunningham's checked in for Bates Diop.
Going second overall in 2019, Ja Morant looks like a franchise cornerstone, carrying Memphis to a play-in game as a rookie.
Wright's gone 50% from the field, 3 out of 6. And Morant gets double-teamed. Here's Diallo. And a great assist by Morant.
Just totally relentless, only increasing the intensity level.
One thing I enjoy is watching players who don't pay attention to the score. Lock in on the moment and play the right way.
Gone, a perfect 3 for 3 here in the fourth. Right wing. Here's Morant. Oh, he hits that one. 8 for 11 and remaining a thorn in the D side.
And trust me, when the D's slow to react, he'll be the first guy to make them pay.
And that's just typical of this guy. He's always reading the situation, reacting quickly, and capitalizing.
And it's Morant with the drive. Capella with a block. Drives to the hoop. Payne. Not going to go that time. Horford with some nice D.
He's been just a little off the mark tonight. Really the story of the game so far.
Pass to Cunningham. Takes the three. Hachimura with a rebound. Hachimura's got his 6th rebound on the night. The 3 from Baines. Nails it from beyond the arc. Baines got 7 now in this quarter.
Wow, you don't see him left alone very often. And of course, he makes good use of it.
Got 4 shots out of 6 attempts to drop so far in the fourth. Now here's Morant. The layup misses.
Despite the miss, those are the kind of looks coaches hope to create.
From deep, Horford pulls it in. They can take their time if they want.
Yes, have to regroup. Make sure you get a good shot.
Yet another assist.
Another possession, another assist.
Man, is he sharing the ball well. Hitting his guys right in their spots. Here's Wright. Another shot. And Capella with the lay-in.
Inside, Capella's physical ability makes the difference. He can get vertical, bump with you, whatever it takes.
Outside Morant. To the inside. That one's good. From Diallo. On the assist by Morant.
And they just continue to attack, even late in the game, while they're up big.
And as a result, they may be facing just a little bit less resistance right now. They are having their way.
He's putting on a lesson in how to distribute the ball. It's been from a point guard. There's been a ton of assists and a lot of other great passes that didn't even make it into the box score.
Ooh, wow. Boy, you can see the amazing relationship he's built with the hometown fans. And it motivates him to always give them his very best. Here's Cunningham. The rebound by Nesmith. Nesmith's got his 4th rebound in this one. Let's it fly. Tried to bank it in, but it misses. Gotten 6 of 10 attempts to drop in the fourth quarter. Pass to Zubats. And a hot call on the way up. So he'll take 2 from the free throw line. It's on Rui Hachimura. And Grant, throughout your career, you mostly played in the smaller markets. Do you think the league is doing enough to help them compete?
I think so. I mean, look, Milwaukee just won a championship. An incredible season they had last year. I think they're doing the right thing between revenue sharing, the salary cap, the luxury tax. And remember, the players' union will always favor freedom of movement for its players.
Pass to Neesmith. Over Williams. They grab their own miss. And the basket by Achimura.
This guy is too powerful and likes and relishes the opportunity to play through contact. Rui doing Rui-like things.
Here's Moran. No good. 3 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Here's the three. Here's Neesmith. The leader falls for it.
Difficult shot.
Another shot right in the lane. That's been their MO this evening.
Outside Morant. Pass to Horford. Zubac inside. Throw the home crowd back here as they get